Hi everyone. I'm feeling much better. I've got a big binder here. I just have to move some stuff so I can open and close it. My first binder. It's all Shannon's fault because she says we should. Well, she didn't say we should. She showed how she stores her images, and what do I say? I gotta say, I love the idea. It's perfect. I've kept mine in boxes, in heaps. So it was a good help at that time for storage organization. So I started, I had these already alphabetized. You probably can't even see that. This is not working. There we go. I guess my batteries are starting to get a little weak. I moved my camera a little, so it's kind of in a bit of a different space. It's angled different, so now I got to be careful that I'm in frame. So anyways, I had these jelly plates that I had done on cardstock, like 90 to 110 pound cardstock. So I just, and I had made a tab system for some other thing before, and I thought, well, I'm not going to throw them away. I'm going to use them. I've got all the tabs ready to go in the back here. Hard to get out right at the moment. And I just used like old cardstock that I've got. I cut 2-inch strips out of 12 by 12 pattern paper and added it to the length of, to extend the length of my jelly prints, because they're only 8.5 by 11, so just running it down the edge of the folded strip here, just down the inside edge of that on both sides. It used to be a folder, so I have all the others over here that I cut off, I think. Oh, I've already put them away somewhere. Okay, so anyways, that's what they were. They were file folders, homemade file folders from Jelly Prints, and then I alphabetized them, and then in these folders, that's how I was keeping my images. So I'm thinking that this is going to work very well. I have, I don't know, Happy Mail. H for Happy Mail. This is Happy Mail that I got from one of the gals on Dee Dee's show on Ustream. And you know what? I looked inside and I didn't mark it. Silly me, didn't mark it, don't remember. So I have all my tabs ready to go, and this is internet. There are places that I've gone on the internet. Some of these have been downloads. I don't know if I'm going to like this camera like this. It's too far away. This is from Ephemera's Vintage Garden. I have purchased some items from her. And yeah. So internet stuff. And then Jay has nothing. K has nothing. L, M. See, I don't even know what my indexes are going to be yet. I don't want to do anything until I get my, like I've ordered two more binders because this is overflowing and I still have more. I can't put nothing else in here. I don't know. Miscellaneous. Yeah, maps and miscellaneous. I haven't got these in a sleeve yet, so they'll get there. I just wanted to get my sides done. So then I started, you know, I did have these for ATCs, so I pulled them out and started cutting numbers, and I think I even have some in pieces. Go back to my faces there. I've been collecting faces for a long time out of magazines. This one's from Bazaar. This one is actually from one of the same ones I did, Art in a Box. It's of the same group, out of the same month and year of Bazaar, and I can't remember what that is. But this one here, I love her. I traced her, but I've done tracings before and they never turn out exactly right. You know, they turn out different. So that's another one. They're sketchy. I love that about them. So, but I do have some. Yeah, here's one. I shouldn't say I have some. I've got, these are too big for the pockets, so I had to put them in like that. But I know I shouldn't have like all these faces, and they're not cut out yet. Like, this is like got sheets and sheets in it. Like many. This one does too. This one has cords. So, yeah, after I finished doing this, oh, and I wanted to show you this tab. T for tissue. I love to print on deli paper or tissue paper. And that's what I've done here. It doesn't matter that it's not mine. I don't plan on selling it. So I can use it for my own personal use. And that's what I do. So some of these I've purchased on Etsy. And some of them I've created myself from pattern paper. These are the hard copies. So no, that's a tissue. Sorry. I do have, this is a tissue. This is a tissue. And I've got them on, I'll show you. I have them on pretty heavy cardstock, and if you see, they're still taped to that cardstock, because that's how I was putting them through my printer. I don't need to do that now, because I've gotten a little smarter since then. Whoops. This is the smaller deli paper, because maybe I only want like half and half. So I have printed full sheets and half sheets, and because I have hordes of deli paper. So tissue paper, like print stuff on tissue paper, and for collage it is amazing what you can do. Like, look at that. I'm gonna open this. I want you to see this guy's face. It's amazing. I don't know where I got this from. Time schedule number 3. Look at that face. I mean, that's just hilarious. Every time I look at it, I laugh. So, okay, these are digital stamps that I've got. Like, you use brushes in Photoshop, and You can bake these a full page or you can make them really tiny. So it's up to you, whatever size you want. They are awesome. Like brushes in Photoshop are amazing. I just love, and you know, my subscribers know that I love working with digital and mixed media. I love combining them. So this was a purchase that I had bought. This one here was actually a napkin. And I scanned it in Photoshop because I didn't want, you know how when, I guess I'm a hoarder. I didn't want to ever not have it. This one here, I actually created this one. I'll show you. In Photoshop. It's actually, Oh, that's tissue paper. Sorry, I'm looking for vintage. Here we go. There it is. I created that in Photoshop and I printed it. Well, I've used part of it, but I printed it on my inkjet printer. And I'm now printing everything from here on in on my laser printer. So I didn't do the back of that, but I copy all my art, and you should too, because you can use it anywhere. This was actually my butterflies folder, and I collaged this and used Photoshop stamps. This was actually off an envelope from, you seem so far away. I can't show you. I gotta move my camera back the way it was. I don't like this. I don't know. There we go. Okay, so this was from an envelope given to me, Happy Mail, and I printed, excuse me, I printed these butterflies on top of some words and that, and these were brushes. This was actually from, oh my goodness. It escapes me now. Oh, it's a fairy tale. Oh my goodness. It's just lost my mind. Okay, it's gone. So I just added a little bit on the back of this because this was quite a decorative folder in the first place. But yeah, it had this butterfly and all of this background. But this and these butterflies here are the ones that I created. So I print, like I say, I print everything. If I find something on the internet, now I got this, I don't know, I got this from somewhere online. I don't know where anymore. Been in my bins forever. I didn't even know I had it. When I was doing journaling by fives, I could have certainly used a binder like this to be able to find stuff. Look at the cute. I've got some cute people. Young girl. Some vintage stamps. Some kind of a form, and that, and this is on deli paper. This is deli paper as well. So is this, and they're still on the backings. So And then, you know, you can print all your words that you want. This is nice for a black and white or a sepia type background. However, it is heavy cardstock. So, or is it just man? Oh, no, that's printed on deli paper. I do have the full sheet of that though. And U has nothing, V is like nothing. And W, I love watches, just like Shannon, like Dee Dee, most people, but I don't have them all. I can't put them in here yet. Some words. And I have lists of words. Like this, that I think I got these on Etsy. I'm not sure. I bought them. This isn't my cup of tea to make up a whole thing like this of words and, you know, little sayings and in Photoshop. Sorry, guys. I'm tired. I had an insomnia night last night. And probably because I've been sleeping so much since I've been sick and I'm not tired. But I am now. Anyways, I just wanted to sort of give you an update on what I've been doing. This has been a huge process and it's still in the works because I'm just waiting for my supplies to come. I wanted to have exactly the same kinds of binders. They didn't have them in white. I would have preferred that, but I've got huge white binders up there for Photoshop and, you know, classes I took way back when, but I'll never give them up. But anyways, that's a binder that I'm working on. And, oops, forgot to put that back. I wanted to talk about yeah, I can't stand this. Hang on one sec. Okay, I reset my camera. I reset my camera and I wanted to talk to you about my journaling in fives process. You know how my pages looked in the fifth part. But I've done a little bit of outlining. I just wanted to sort of give you just a quick update. And some of the photos that I had in here I didn't like, and I found better ones. So, and I haven't done anything more with this but get him down. There will be more happening to this page because I don't like, I don't even like this word. I'll be sanding that down. And actually, that was a little tip I'll give you. If you've glued something down and you can't pick it up, I have the Tim Holtz Ideology sander, and it really takes these edges down so that when you glue something else over it or if you paint over it, you don't see the lines. And I love that. So I use my sander. I'm using my sander a lot in this project. Not that I've used it, you know, so much in the past. Now you remember my owl. Well, this whole page has changed. I'm going to pull this out because it makes it dark. The whole page has changed because I didn't like what I had here for imagery. And I love this page. Now, I worked on this last night. And where am I? Oh, my God. Yeah, I worked on this last night. And, yeah, I love it now. So, the ones I don't like, I'm just going to paint over them. You know, that's just how it is. This one here, I have a plan for. And I think it'll be great. See, I haven't done so much. I've gone around this flower. I haven't done much here. I'm not sure how much I've done. And things are sticking. This one here is I call done. And yeah, I call it done. And this one here is probably going to get covered over because I don't know what to put with it. It's kind of one of those images that you throw down in a hurry and I never thought about it. So that'll change. This one here, I don't know. We'll see. I haven't gotten to too much more in here, but you know, it's a work in progress. I'm going to continue. I want to finish this whole book. This is going to be a fun page. I like this one. I like this one too. And this one's cute. So, yeah. Like I say, if you like one image and you don't like anything else, if at all possible, and you can work it out, you know, just go ahead and paint over it. Like, paint everything up. But I used the sandblock around the other images that I had down here. And I never thought, you know, there was many things I could have done with these feathers. I made them more painterly is what I did, but had I been thinking, I could have had something peeking out here or back in here. But as it looks right now, it looks like it's gone into the basket with its head. It's flown into the basket. That's my opinion, but like when you look at it, I want you to have your own artist impression. Like, I'm sort of understanding what Dee Dee has been saying in her classes that she does on Ustream, as they're not really classes, but you know what I mean. She talks about, she never puts words on. She never puts the words on. She leaves it totally up to the viewer. But this is an art journal, so, you know, we put words on. So I didn't know, I couldn't find any words that suited this page, so I just printed them on my printer. What a hoot. Outlined them, you know, in pen, and yeah, so that's kind of what I did. Just giving you an idea that, you know, if the page is just like really doesn't suit your style or it's turned out really crappy, like I've had a few, I'll tell you. yeah, I'm gonna paint it out, and I don't know, everything I need comes to me at the perfect time. Doesn't suit this picture now, so I may paint this out and then sand all this down so that, you know, it's not going to affect my paint, so it's not going to leave lines. I don't want that. So we'll see what happens. I'm not sure what I'm doing with this yet, but it does look to me like it should be almost Zentangled, but I've never done Zentangle, so we'll see. I don't know. And yeah, that image may go, I don't know. Things are going to be changing here pretty soon in my book. So I just thought I'd come back and say that I'm alive and I'm much better and I've been doing stuff and I'm enjoying my studio and I'm back to arting almost like before. I want to get back doing a few journal in a box, a few more of those, start whipping them up like more than once every month or, you know, once every whenevers. I love doing them. But anyway, before I go, There's a surprise coming. You might already know about it, but I'm not saying anything until it's been aired. So, take care. Bye for now.